Hello dear students, welcome to the second video of the first chapter Introduction to Java. In earlier video, we have seen the basic features of Java and brief history of Java. In this video, I am going to present the comparison between Java and C++, as well as to introduce about Java environment and Java tools. Now let us start with the comparison of Java with C++ with respect to some general issues. As you know, C++ is very popular object-oriented programming language. It was widely used before the advent of Java. Java resembles the syntax of C++, but there are several differences between these two languages. Java has left out some of the complex and confusing concepts that were used in C++, or some concepts are modified by Java and some are newly added. If you see the pre-processing, what is pre-processing? Before compilation starts, preprocessor processes some preprocessing statements. Macro is one of the example. Macro is processed or executed before compilation starts. This concept was in C++, but in Java, this preprocessor concept is totally removed. Second point is about structures and unions. In C++, structures and unions are used to group data atoms. All may not be of the same type. But in Java, this structures and union concept is totally new because collection of data atoms of different types can be added into class itself, because class also contains the collection of variables and all of different types. Third point is now about command line arguments. What is command line arguments? That you know that whenever you are executing your program from the command prompt of operating system, then in C++, command line arguments also includes the name of program. However, in Java, program name is not as a part of command line arguments. So these are the differences by considering general issues. Let us come to the second category about object-oriented issues. C++ is the hybrid language, we can say. It is in between procedural and object-oriented. It is not a pure object-oriented. Java is a pure object-oriented because everything is in terms of objects and classes. Let us come to the second point, is that in C++ you can write any function outside the class. But in Java, functions are also called as a methods, must be part of the class. You cannot write a function or method outside the class. That's why Java is called pure object oriented. Everything is inside a class. Then next point is about multiple inheritance. What is multiple inheritance? Two or more classes can derive a single class. That is called as the multiple inheritance. C++ supports multiple inheritance. However, this concept is removed from Java. Java does not support multiple inheritance. So, if such a problem of multiple inheritance is to be attempted into Java, then it supports a concept of interfaces that we will see in next videos. Then next point is about operator overloading. What is operator overloading? Single operator, we can assign more than one meanings. In C++, as we know, plus is an operator that is used to add two numbers. But we can use that plus to concatenate two strings. We can use this plus as an operator to add two time objects containing hours and minutes. In Java, Java does not support operator overloading. It has its own facility. Some built-in support is already provided that does the task of operator overloading. Next is dynamic binding. In C++, only virtual functions are dynamically bound. Dynamically, it can bound to any of the object which invokes it. But in Java, all methods or functions are dynamically bound, depend upon who invokes that method. Last point about object-oriented issue is, in C++, objects are passed to methods by value or reference. Whenever you do parameter passing to method or function, so object can be passed as a value or reference. In Java, every object, whenever it is passed as a parameter to method, it is only by reference. So therefore, when callee modifies the object, caller will automatically fetch the content of the modified object. Now let us come to the next issue or category related to comparative study of C++ and Java. Arrays, pointers and strings. If you see multi-dimensional array, take an example of matrix. There are number of rows and number of columns. Here in C++, all array lengths have the same sizes. That means all rows having same number of columns. So in Java, that is not the issue. Array lengths can vary for each element within one dimension. Means in matrix, if you consider, each row may not have the same number of columns. First row may have 3 columns, second row may have 4 columns, third row may have only 2 columns. Means that number of columns in each row can vary in Java. That facility is provided. Second point is bound checking on array. There is no bound checking. Means in C++, if you trying to add store element, that is, does not store element into a location of array that does not exist, you will get runtime error. That bound checking is not possible by the programmer. At runtime, you will get error. However, in Java, there is an exception handling mechanism is there. So there is an exception, array index out of bounds can be used to check array bounds. So at compilation time, you will get an exception check so that it will not allow to store element out of array bounds. Next point is pointers. C++ supports pointers with different operators. However, Java does not support pointer. That memory addressing pointers are internally handled by Java environment itself. Next is about strings. What are the strings in C++? Null terminated character arrays are called as strings. String is simply an array of characters terminated by \0. In Java, strings are objects itself. If there is a class named string, we can create object of that string class. In C++, all string operations are performed using functions. There is a library is provided in C++ to perform string operations. Java provides a string as a class, so it provides a built-in operators in that. So that string class contains different methods, and through operators we can call those methods. Built-in string operators are there. That means to add two strings, concatenate two string plus operator is there. Next difference about the special features. C++ programs are compiled, you will get a machine code, and that those can be executed. Whereas Java programs are compiled, it creates a bytecode instruction, those are executed by Java virtual machine, that means Java interpreter. Means Java programs are compiled as well as interpreted. So C++ is the architecture specific. Means whatever program we have compiled for one computer architecture, it may not possible to execute on another computer architecture or platform. However, Java is architectural neutral because Java compiler creates architectural neutral bytecode instructions, and those can be executed on specific computer through Java virtual machine. C++ does not have a concept of interface. Java supports interface instead of multiple inheritance. Now next point is about multithreading. Multithreading is what single application can be divided into multiple tasks. Each task is called as a thread, and all those threads can execute simultaneously to utilize the CPU time and IO time. C++ does not support multithreading. Java supports to write application in multithreading environment. Next and last point is web-based application. C++ does not support web-based application development mechanism. Whereas Java supports different libraries for developing web-based applications. So these are about the comparative study of C++ and Java with respect to various issues. Let us come to the next point about Java environment. Java is not just a programming language. So what is it? It is a complete technology. It includes various parts. First, programming language. Java is a pure object-oriented programming language. Second component is what? Development environment. Java development tools provide the programmer everything that is needed for compilation, execution, then debugging, as well as documenting applications. Next is Java provides application environment. That it provides APR, application programming interface. That provides the core functionality of Java programming language. It offers a huge collection of classes containing methods which can be directly used in applications. Instead of API provides predefined classes and packages that can be directly used in our applications. Fourth components of Java environment is a deployment environment. The Java technology provides standard mechanisms such as Java Web Start, and Java plugin for deploying the applications used for Java users. And last component is integration libraries, such as Java database connectivity, Java naming and directory interface, JNDR, Java remote method invocation, RMI, Java messaging service, JMS. So these API enable communication between database, heterogeneous, remote, or various distributed objects. Means Java is not simply a programming language. It is a complete technology. It includes the object-oriented language, development environment, application environment, deployment environment, and integration libraries. Now let us come to the what are the different components of Java platforms. Java platform includes two main components. One is Java Virtual Machine. It is the base for Java platform, and this JVM is ported on various hardware-based platforms. The concept of write once, run anywhere is used with Java programs. Means the Java programs are compiled by Java compiler and it creates Java bytecode. Those Java bytecode instructions can be portable on any architecture or any platform where JVM is installed. JVM interprets that bytecode instruction, execute, that is, on suitable platform or architecture where it is going to execute. So this is about JVM. Second component is Java API. Is a large collection of predefined components that provide various capabilities such as graphical user interface, event handling, I/O handling, file handling, networking. All these APIs are provided by Java platform. So these Java APIs are grouped into different libraries of related classes and interfaces, and these libraries are known as packages. So these are the two main components of Java platform, that is JVM and Java API. Now Java programs, actually whenever we develop a Java application or program, that comes in different forms. Four different forms are there. One is Java application. Java applications are the programs which run on standalone systems or local networks. What are the applets? Java applets are Java programs that run on web browsers, that is on internet. Java servers, Java servlets basically are the another third type of programs which are run on web servers. So web servers basically holds Java servlets which can be invoked by clients. And then last fourth type of Java program is midlets, that is on mobile devices, whatever Java programs you are running which are called Java midlets. So these are the four main types of Java programs. Now in this semester we are going to study Java applications and Java applets. In next semester we will study Java servlets. Basically Java editions. Now whenever we come to the Java platform, there are many versions of Java standard editions are available. To develop standalone or client-side applications as well as applets, the Java standard edition is used. Then Enterprise edition is used to develop server-side programs, that is servlets and distributed applications. And third edition is micro edition, which is used to develop mobile applications, that is midlets, as well as wireless applications. So there are three editions: Java standard editions for developing standalone programs or client-side programs, as well as applets running on internet. Java enterprise edition is used especially for developing server-side programs and distributed applications. Last edition is Java Micro Edition for mobile devices, applications and wireless applications. So let us come to the versions, Java Standard Edition versions, which versions are currently available. Now with each version, Sun Microsystems releases a Java Development Kit, JDK. To start creating Java programs, many developers begin with the software development kit that comes under a JDK. What JDK contains? JDK contains mainly two parts: Java runtime environment and set of libraries for your programs. The combination of this runtime environment and this library we call as a Java platform. JDK Java Development Kit comes with Java runtime environment and set of libraries for developing application, and this called as a Java platform. Before 1998, we called Java platform as a Java. Later on, after that, it is renamed to Java 2. So there are many versions of Java that are available. Means JDK versions are available. So what is the latest version of the Java platform standard edition? So in March 2020, this JDK 14 has been launched, and it is expected that JDK 15 will be launched in this month, September 2020. So these are the various edition available. Next we come to the Integrated Development Environment, IDE. Basically, when we write a Java program, we will use a simple editor at the beginning, then on command prompt we will compile the Java program and execute it. But there are different integrated development environments available, which combines the all different features of editing your program, compiling your program, building your program, debugging the program, as well as the online help for Java environment. Everything combined in one integrated development environment for developing different Java applications. IDE is available. Eclipse is one of the widely used integrated development environments. NetBeans is also there. JBuilder is there. So there are different development environments are available for developing Java applications, which combines editing, compiling, interpreter, debugging, as well as online help features. At the beginning, we'll be using a normal editor and we'll compile on command prompt. Later on, in the second semester, we'll go for integrated development environment for Java application development. Let us see now, next is Java tools. Next, Java tools, there are various tools are available, but basically only some of the tools that we are going to see here. Others tools will be discussed as and when required during this semester. First tool is a Java C, that is a Java compiler. We'll be using these tools to convert your Java source code into Java bytecode, bytecode instructions. Then will be given to Java interpreter. Java is a Java interpreter that execute that bytecode instruction and gives the result. Third tool is a Java doc that is used for creating HTML help file from Java source code. Means you can give a Java special comments, and with help of Java community, that we can create Java HTML file. That is a help file of your program. But practically, whenever we'll see, you'll be more clear about Java doc. Similarly for other tools also. JDB is a tool that for जी, और डिबगिंग जावा प्रोग्राम्स विल बी यूजिंग जावा पी. टूल इज यूज टू जस्ट लिस्ट आउट द विच आर द मेथड्स और फंक्शंस इन अ विच आर द डिफरेंट क्लासेस अवेलेबल इन पर्टिकुलर प्रोग्राम. देन जावा एच इज वन अदर टूल टू जनरेट हेडर फाइल. हेडर फाइल जनरेटर यूज वाइल कंबाइनिंग जावा एंड सी प्लस प्लस प्रोग्राम टूगेदर. जार इज अनदर टूल फॉर जावा आरक्यू मैनेजमेंट. इट कंबाइंस एंड कंप्रेसेस मल्टीपल फाइल्स इनटू वन. मीन्स मल्टीपल डॉट क्लास फाइल्स और डॉट जावा फाइल्स कैन बी कंबाइंड टूगेदर टू क्रिएट वन डॉट जार फाइल इफ यू वांट टू कैरी इट एट अनदर प्लेस. दैट इज अ जार आरक्यू मैनेजर. नेक्स्ट इज अ एप्लेट व्यूअर. Whenever we develop a special type of Java program, those are called as applets, which we can run on web browsers. So, to applet can be launch, can be execute on applet viewer. If you don't have a web browser, we can run that Java applet on applet viewer. So, this is about the Java tools, and that's all about different. That is comparison. Of Java with C++, we have seen what is a Java environment and different Java tools. In next video, we are going to start with how to write Java program, how to compile and execute it. Thank you. Thank you very much.